Madam Rajavi, thank you so much for providing the opportunity today for us to come together. I believe the world owes yourself and the Iranian resistance movement a huge debt of gratitude for your strength and your courage and your leadership on these issues. Today is a chance for us to reflect on how do we take the message to the rest of the world and all of the others to pay attention to what is happening right before our eyes and to put their support behind the PMOI and Madam Rajavi and the Iran resistance movement. And how do we tell the rest of the world what is going on and enlist their support? And I have to say it's a huge honor to see the strength and the leadership that is being shown by yourself and so many. Yesterday, the one thing that really stood out for me when the cameras would flash across the screen was the strength of the women, of the Iranian women, who will not stand back and see their people destroyed, and that they will lead. Today, as hopefully as what will come out of the discussion today, is some ideas as to how we can unite the world behind the Iranian resistance movement.
Thank you very much, and President-elect Madam Rajavi, it's an honor to be in your presence. My wife Frances and I managed to come here yesterday, and it was indeed a very impressive turn of events. You yourself, what a glow of light you are for freedom in the world, but the words you give need to be heard worldwide. I think there was a number of things happened yesterday and said yesterday. The idea that you, with your capabilities, would and then get interviewed in the worldwide networks around the world so they could hear what you have to say and to understand fully what a threat Iran is to you, but also to I and to my people and the people I live with, because if this regime becomes a nuclear power, what happens? But I think you have your voice. You have the ability. You're blessed with the ability to be able to motivate people, because you sure did it yesterday. And the most important thing, I would believe, is the world hears what you have to say. If there's any one point I would like to leave, is that what you and your government in exile has to say is heard by the world, and also to understand what happens if this regime is able, though it might be weakened, but is able to become a nuclear power, and what it would do. Thank you very much.